Welcome to Chapter 1, Quality Control. This module will help you create a strong foundation in laboratory basics. Let's begin with the question, what is quality control? Quality control in the medical laboratory is a statistical process used to monitor and evaluate the analytical process that produces patient results. This definition may cause you to ask, what are the requirements of statistical process? Here are the two requirements. Regular testing of quality control products along with patient samples, and comparison of quality control results to specific statistical limits. When a diagnostic test is performed in the medical laboratory, the outcome of the test is a result. The result may be a patient result, or it may be a quality control QC result. The result may be quantitative, a number, or qualitative, positive or negative, or semi-quantitative, limited to a few different values. QC results are used to validate whether the instrument is operating within predefined specifications, inferring that patient test results are reliable. Once the test system is validated, patient results can then be used for diagnosis, prognosis, or treatment planning. For example, when a patient's serum is assayed, tested for potassium, the test result tells us how much potassium concentration is present in the blood. This result is then used by the physician to determine whether the patient has a low, normal, or high potassium. Let's assume the measured value of potassium in a patient's serum is 2.8 millimoles per liter. This result is abnormally low and indicates an inappropriate loss of potassium. But how does the person performing the test know that this result is truly reliable? One possible cause could be that the instrument is out of calibration, and the patient's true potassium value is 4.2 millimole per liter, a normal result. The question of reliability for most testing can be resolved by regular use of quality control materials and statistical process control. A quality control product is a patient-like material, ideally made from human serum, urine, or spinal fluid. A control product can be a liquid or freeze-dried, lyophilized material, and is composed of one or more constituents, analytes of known concentration. Control products should be tested in the same manner as patient samples. A quality control product usually contains many different analytes. For example, a general chemistry control can contain any number of chemistry analytes, including potassium, glucose, albumin, and calcium. A normal control product contains normal levels for the analyte being tested. An abnormal control product contains the analyte at a concentration above or below the normal range for the analyte. For example, the normal range for a potassium level is about 3.5 to 5.0 millimole per liter. A normal control would contain potassium at a level within this range. An abnormal control would contain potassium at a level below 3.5 millimole per liter or above 5.0 millimole per liter. Good laboratory practice requires testing normal and abnormal controls for each test at least daily to monitor the analytical process. If the test is stable for less than 24 hours, or some change has occurred which could potentially affect the test stability, controls should be assayed more frequently. Regular testing of quality control products creates a QC database that the laboratory uses to validate the test system. Validation occurs by comparing daily QC results to a laboratory-defined range of QC values. The lab-defined range is calculated from QC data collected from testing of normal and abnormal controls. In Table 1, there are two ranges reported. The acceptable range for the Level 1, also referred to as the normal control, is 3.7 to 4.3 millimol per liter. The range for Level 2, also referred to as the abnormal control, is 6.7 to 7.3 millimol per liter. When the daily QC result obtained for the normal control is compared to the range calculated for the normal control, it becomes apparent that each result lies somewhere within the expected range. This indicates that the analytical process is in control at the normal level on that day of testing. When the daily QC result for the abnormal control, high potassium, is compared to the defined range for the abnormal control, the analytical process is shown to be in control for each day of testing, except for the last day, November 7th. On November 1st through November 6th, both controls were in control, and patient values could be reliably reported. However, the laboratory was out of control for abnormal high potassiums on November 7th because the value obtained for the QC material, 8.0 millimol per liter, was outside the acceptable range, 6.7 to 7.3 millimol per liter. This means that some error occurred which may have made some patient results unreliable. The laboratory should not report any patient samples with an abnormally high potassium result until the error is resolved and the abnormally high samples are retested. Perhaps it's now apparent that the range defined for each level of control is fundamental to the quality control system. The next section describes how to calculate the basic statistics required to develop an acceptable control range. We've reached the end of this module. Let's review some basic points. Quality control in the medical laboratory is a statistical process used to monitor and evaluate the analytical process that produces patient results. There are two requirements for the statistical process: regular testing of quality control products, along with patient samples, and comparison of quality control results to specific statistical limits. Test results may be a patient result, or it may be a quality control QC result. Results may be quantitative, a number, or qualitative, positive or negative, or semi-quantitative, limited to a few different values. QC results are used to validate whether the instrument is operating within predefined specifications, inferring that patient test results are reliable. Millimoles per liter is a unit of measure abbreviated as mmol per L. A quality control product is a patient-like material ideally made from human serum, urine, or spinal fluid. A control product can be a liquid or freeze-dried, lyophilized material and is composed of one or more constituents, analytes, of known concentration. A quality control product usually contains many different analytes. A normal control product contains normal levels for the analyte being tested. An abnormal control product contains the analyte at a concentration above or below the normal range for the analyte. Good laboratory practice requires testing normal and abnormal controls for each test at least daily to monitor the analytical process. When the daily QC results are within the expected range, the analytical process is in control. When the daily QC results are outside of the expected range, the analytical process is out of control. For all of your laboratory QC needs, go to www.qcnet.com.